From where we get our gene of interest for gene cloning? One of the sources is Genomic Library, other source is CDNA Library. In this video, let us understand what is Genomic Library. Genomic Library, as the term indicates, it is a library or collection of cloned DNA fragments of an organism. It represents an entire genome of individual animal, plant, bacteria or virus under study. Or it's a collection or library of cloned segments of DNA containing at least one copy of every gene from a particular organism. Let's take an example to understand the concept of genomic library. Construction of genomic library of a phage. Phages are viruses that attack bacteria. So this is a bacteriophage. So we are going to construct the genomic library of this phage. First, we need to isolate the DNA. So suppose this is the DNA of the phage, it is a very small genome. Then we need to cut this isolated DNA using suitable restriction enzyme into suitable sized fragments. So these are the fragments A, B, C, D, E. So these are the genes of the phage, only 5 genes. Now what we do next is incorporate these fragments into a suitable vector like plasmid, cosmid, etc. So I have introduced this each gene into different plasmid vector. So you can see the color A, B, C, D and E. So I have incorporated the gene fragment into suitable vector. As we discussed in the previous video, we will be using restriction enzymes and ligases for making this recombinant vector. Now we have plasmid vector with our DNA fragment. Next step is introduction of this recombinant plasmid into suitable host like bacterium. That is followed by multiplication, screening and identification and characterization of clones or colonies that contain these genes. So after screening and characterization, we have colonies with A gene, B gene, C gene, D gene and E gene. So these, as this is a plasmid, this will replicate inside the bacteria. So many copies of that particular gene is there as colonies of bacteria. So this is colony containing the A fragment or A gene, and this is a colony containing the B fragment or B gene, a C fragment or C gene, and this is D fragment or D gene, and finally we have E gene. So this collection of cloned DNA fragments that is maintained is called genomic library of this phage. Let me repeat, this phage has 5 genes and these 5 genes are maintained as bacterial colonies containing cloned DNA fragment. This maintenance of set of clones is called as genomic library. For an experiment, if I require C gene, then I will be isolating C gene from this particular colony, that is from genomic library. In short, genomic library represents cloned DNA fragments of an organism that is maintained as colonies. Let me summarize the steps in the construction of genomic library. First, we need to isolate the genome DNA from cell under study. It can be from virus, bacteria, animals, plant cells, etc. Then cutting isolated DNA using suitable restriction enzyme into suitable sized fragments. Then incorporation of these fragments into a suitable vector. Screening, identification and characterization of clones after transformation experiment or introduction of this vector into a suitable host. And finally, maintenance of such set of clones containing cloned DNA fragments of that particular organism under study is called genomic library. The source of our gene of interest is this genomic library.